working on this 55. Got a few little sill plates and a patch panel that we're gonna put in here. It's got a little rust issues. Got this thing loose. Get all this cleaned up and fixed. I want to show you guys something. You guys ever have these screws that are just stripped out? Phillips head, can't get it out. Instead of grinding it all the way down, I mean, sometimes you gotta use a drill, but it's a little trick I made up. Then you can use a flathead screwdriver and take it out. All right, got the old seal plates off. There's the new ones. Probably install those after I get this patch panel in. All right, got the panel out. A lot of the times these things are spot welded to the bracing underneath and you just gotta drill them out. So that one's out. Cut and fit this new panel. And start welding it in. All right, got the panel all cut to fit. Start tacking it all in. Looks pretty good. Fitment's good on this one. So now I'm just trimming up the excess parts to weld it all in. Usually you can like overlap it, drill holes, spot weld it in, but I kind of like it all welded solid. Takes a little bit longer, but it looks nicer when you get it done. It's crazy, it looks like you just screwed everything up, but it'll look brand new when I get done. All right, got the panel in, gonna start tacking it all in place. Like tight right here. Cut the excess off. Get this pinch weld all placed, drilled, and tacked in. And then, show you what it looks like when it's all welded in. Then we got these on the site, thecoffinmuffler.com. If you need some nice work gloves with a lot of padding, real goat skin. Hit up the site. Alright, got it all welded in. Came up pretty nice, real tight fit. Looks really good. I'll go back and grind all the welds, smooth it all off, probably undercoat it and put it on the rack, clean up the underside. There's another panel that goes from here. It's like a brace. And I'll go from the underside and just tack everything up to where everything's solid, nothing rattles. A lot of people have their own ways of doing patch panels. We got a bead roller finally, so I mean, I can make all this up, but this customer brought us a panel. I don't know who the manufacturer is, but it's a really nice one. Little bit more length on either side so you can trim it to fit. A lot of people, they'll just overlap them, plug weld everything, and then seam seal it. I like to take a little bit more time and weld them in solid. That way I know nothing's going anywhere. Takes a little bit more time, but it's gonna look good when it's all finished up. All right, got it all grinded smooth. Smoothed off all the welds. I think now I'll just wipe it all down. spray some undercoat over it, and put it on the rack and look at the underside and make sure everything's good. But that's pretty much it with these patch panels. It's a little bit of effort getting these things in, but it's well worth it. And most of the cars these days, they're all gonna have some sort of rust on them. So this is a great way to make your car worth a lot more money. Cut out all that rust. All right, I got the door sills in. New hardware all bolted up. The patch panel in. Now it's ready for undercoat. That's it on this one. Nice little 55.